Us. We're in our Marvel t-shirts, and you want to tell them why we're wearing Marvel t-shirts?
Because we're celebrating Comic-Con.
Comic-Con.
Hello, everybody.
Hey, everybody. How's it going today?
If you don't already know, my name's Kathy.
My name's Tom.
And we are the Marvelous Donahues.
We are the Marvelous Donahues. And just to promote our Marvelous, we are wearing our Marvel t-shirts. And you want to tell them why we're wearing Marvel t-shirts?
Because we're celebrating Comic-Con.
Comic-Con.
And we will have videos about that a little bit later. So stay tuned for those.
That's right.
If you don't know who we are, like I said, I'm Kathy, and this is my fabulous, marvelous husband, Tom. And we have two stations on this one platform, right? We have the Marvelous Donahue Life, and we have the Marvelous Donahues, right?
That's right.
So there's one, the Marvelous Donahue Life. We talk about retirement and us retiring in Europe sooner than later. And we'll also be talking about just how we're going to do that, what we're doing.
That's right.
How we're doing it. And if you haven't already saw some of those videos, we'll put a link up here or down there so you can do it. So, and the second station is the, not station, but the second station on this platform. I guess I can say that, right?
Yeah, you can say that.
Is we talk about Marvel, everything Marvel. As you can see, we are Marvel fans for real.
We are.
And our next video, we're going to be talking about Comic-Con. You guys, those tickets sold out.
That's
we
right.
could, look, I don't even know who you got to know. So, if you know somebody who can get us tickets to Comic-Con, because it was so many.
Maybe Robert Downey or Kevin Feige or somebody like that. Just shoot them our way.
Yeah, so we will sit in the hallway and just talk to people that are passing by. Look, I don't care. Just want to get there in the hallway. In the hallway.
In the hallway. In the hallway. But we'll do one of the next videos or two. We'll actually do some reaction video on kind of what happened to Comic-Con, like what we think, and maybe we'll even maybe do a costume judging contest. We'll tell you what people are wearing and who wore it best.
Right.
Something like that.
And also, I guess I'll put my other channel in here, Kathy's Book Club. I'm going to plug for that because I'm really going to start doing stuff with that. I want to talk about just some things that I've been going through as we transition to retirement and just some personal struggles that I've been having for a long time. And I want to share those as a veteran so I can help other people.
That's right. And speaking of retirement, for those of you who have been following or not been following, I got my Irish citizenship. Check our videos out about how I got my Irish citizenship in case you're interested in getting yours.
Yes.
It is possible.
It is possible.
It was about a week or so ago. I got a great surprise in the mail, which was my Irish passport.
Yes. So you got it.
I'm like a hurdler. I finished hurdle one was getting my citizenship. Hurdle two was getting my... This is kind of like the Olympics. I'm doing the hurdling thing.
Ooh, the Olympics, you guys. We have been watching them. Quincy, we're watching the Samoa. We're watching the swimming. We're watching the equestrian.
Just pick a sport.
We have handball, badminton.
Saw some judo, too.
Oh, skateboarding, you know. So we're just all over it. So we are loving the Olympics. We are loving life, and we just wanted to get on here and tell you guys that we love you, and we're gonna come back to making videos. You know, like I said on my other station, I'll just talk about just some personal things that I've been going through that I wasn't able to be fully committed, but I do like what we're doing. I do enjoy Marvel, and I want to continue doing that.
That's right. And let's catch people up on some of the Marvel things going on.
Okay.
We've heard, which you can talk to us about. So Kevin Feige, I understand, got a star on the Walk of Life or the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Walk of Life, Walk of Fame, whatever they call it, from Big Wigs.
He has. The other day, over the weekend, he received a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. And to me, Tom, it's been a long time coming.
Yes, it has been.
It has been a long time coming. And I believe that it was well deserved.
It is.
I know there's such a controversy regarding Marvel, the movies, and just their standing when it comes to, oh, they're not serious movies. But I want to tell you guys that I'm an amateur playwright myself, and I try to dabble in writing different series myself. But I know from a fact, and as an amateur writer, if you can make people connect with the character, you know, that's what sells. You know, you have a believability and an authenticity that comes with the Marvel characters. That's I know some of the movies didn't work, like the Black Widow. I'm not saying it didn't work, because I could feel and see where they were going with that, right? But when I think about, you know, I'm biased anyway, I'm just going to tell you, right? I'm thinking about Captain America and the old Captain America and Captain America and the Winter Soldier. Those two, the Captain America movie, the first Avenger, you knew, you know, Steve, you know, you connected with him. He was a short, you know, small guy, had been that way his whole life, and he had the opportunity to change his life by volunteering and doing something he always wanted to do. And he also had people that believed in him. So, oh my gosh, you know, that's the story that people can connect with. And you can root for, you know?
It kind of reminds you of, you know, being the picked on kid in school. You know, I used to talk about, you know, hey, who are the high school bullies that bully people? And then who are the picked on people? Hey, Steve Rogers, one of those picked on people.
I know.
But speaking of Chris Evans, and we might as well talk about Robert Downey Jr. too. Nothing official with Chris, but we heard that he might try to come back in the Marvel Cinematic Universe is something. Don't know how that's going to work, but tell them about Robert Downey Jr.
Oh my gosh, you guys. So, you all know this already. If you are Marvel heads like we are, okay? You know that the announcement of Robert Downey Jr. coming back as Dr. Doom really surprised people, gasped, audible gasp in the audience, screams, cries, cheers and jeers, you know, because they're like, what? After him playing and portraying Iron Man for all this time, how in the world is he gonna come back as Dr. Doom? So I'm excited to see that.
That's right. And of course, those of you who don't know the character Dr. Doom, that's from Victor Doom, who was turned out to be eventually the nemesis, the grand nemesis of Fantastic Four. So we're going to see how that all comes out. I think we hear that John Krasinski is going to be Mr. Fantastic. I don't know who all the rest are going to be that I've really kept up with.
If you guys know, let us know. Because I heard too, but we have not watched it, there is a leaked video of the Fantastic Four and who is going to be in that. So I'm excited about seeing that.
The Fantastic Four were one of my favorite childhood heroes or groups of heroes, because I used to cut out little comic strips for those of you who are old enough, and this may be like an old fogey alert, but we used to cut out comic strips, cartoons, and used to put them in scrapbooks and kind of keep them. But Fantastic Four. So we're looking forward to that. And what's going on with Robert Downey? We'll find out what's going to be like.
How are we ever going to see him as anything else? Yeah. You know, because I would tell you guys, Endgame's been around for a long time, right? But whenever I watch that and he slipped the other hand, on the other guy's hand, and then he snaps his fingers. He was like, you know, I've got the power now. It's like, it moves me beyond belief. And I don't care what anybody says. Those movies are moving. Those movies connect.
And why didn't any of the Marvel movies get an Oscar? What?
Or even a nomination.
If you guys can tell me the secret riddle behind that, I'd really like to know.
I know that they think that they're not real movies. And I will tell you one thing, too. And we're going to review this. We're going to have to go back. Tom's got his Loki hairstyle. But we're going to have to go back and review that last Loki. Because... listen, it was everything, and I wanted to review it, but, you know, we'll go into some of that later, but I will tell you, when I watched it, I was like, the creativity is astounding. You know, I believe that when they started the multiverse and when they started all these layers, mm-hmm. right? I know that some people don't like them. They're like, oh, it's too much. It's too hard to understand. But I feel like if you believe, and guess what? I don't have to say I believe in aliens anymore, unidentified flying objects and all those things. They've been studying them for years, and there's something going on. So
they're here among us.
Yeah, don't even say that I'm crazy for thinking that, because... the U.S. government has already proven it.
That's true.
Yeah, I mean, that guy, it was so much going on. So when that guy was like, oh, I've worked with aliens, I saw the technology and all that kind
of... We were watching the news one night, and they go, there are aliens out there. The U.S. government's confirmed aliens do exist, and now on to sports. We're like, wait a minute, what?
When did that happen?
What happened? Wait a minute, what?
Yeah, and then go back... find that guy. And this isn't just crazy talk. This guy is a regular guy. He worked for the U.S. government. He's like, there's tons of this stuff out there.
That's right.
There's tons of stuff. And I'm not like trying to be a you know, whatever. But it's what it is. You know?
The truth is out there.
Yeah,
exactly. As Chris Carter from X-Files once said years ago, the truth is out there.
It is. But you guys, listen, we will not hold you. We're going to
do some more videos.
We are.
So we'll have a passport video.
Yes, we're going to have
other one? We're going to have the Comic-Con reaction
video. Yes.
Because we're going to watch some Comic-Con, and we're going to look at what's going on in Comic-Con.
I did not watch the announcement for Robert Downey Jr. because I wanted to make sure Tom could watch it. We could see it at the same time. This is how committed I am to Marvel, because I want us to see it at the same time. If you have not seen our Kang video and us watching a reaction to that, I'm going to link that somewhere down here too, because it is classic. I mean... It's awesome.
And who will be king? I don't know.
Did they say that one guy might be?
It was the character from Mandalorian. Lord, remember the guy that had kidnapped baby Grogu?
Yeah, yeah.
And he was doing the old knife. I think we won't tell him the ending, he got clobbered.
Yeah. Who can stand up to baby Grogu, okay? But listen, you guys, we are not going to make this too long. I know people are like... videos have got longer. We see some for 2-3 hours. I just can't. I don't have that much talking to do. And thank you guys for liking and subscribing. Please pass these videos along to your friend. We are trying to marvel and march ahead to 300. We are at 203. We haven't done anything to go viral yet. I don't even know what that's all about.
You can help us with that.
Yes.
No homework really, but yeah. If you have 600 friends,
yeah.
Here's what we need to do. We need to have you, just like the election, just tell your friends and your friends and your friends and say, hey, check these guys out.
Exactly. Exactly. All right, you guys. Good to see you.
Take care.
My name is Kathy.
My name's Tom.
And we will see you next time.
See you next time, everybody.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.